The St. Croix River Valley is experiencing a long-awaited addition with construction of the new St. Croix Crossing. The bridge will connect St. Joseph, Wisconsin and Oak Park Heights, Minnesota, and replaces the Stillwater Lift Bridge. Construction began in 2013, and the bridge will open to traffic in fall 2016. The bridge's foundations includes an element called caissons, and these caissons extend up to 140 feet below the water surface. As of today, all bridge work below the water is complete.
The early foundation contractor used a precast cofferdam system. That is the first time we've used this system in Minnesota.
To get the bridge foundations started, crews floated in a prefabricated steel framing system and then poured a concrete deck topping that served as a work platform. The platform included four large circular holes. These holes served as a guide for placing the casings, which are hollow and made of steel. There are four caissons per pier column and 10 pier columns in the river. The casings, which is one part of a caisson, were placed through the platform openings, extended into the water and muck, down to the bedrock beneath the river bottom. Before reaching the bedrock, the casings passed through up to 25 feet of water, up to 87 feet of muck, 2 feet of sand and gravel, and 2 feet of soft sandstone. The next step was removing all of the muck and gravel from inside these 40 steel casings that extend to bedrock. Crews used many tools to excavate the material, but the water remained inside each casing during this work. Still, the foundation of the bridge needed to extend deeper into the rock. Crews drilled an additional 25 feet into the bedrock to secure each foundation. They used massive drill bits that measured up to 7.5 feet in diameter to break up and remove the rock. The process removed 2,500 dump truck loads of sand, muck, and gravel that went to a landfill.
The caissons are roughly 125 feet below footing, and so about 150 feet below the water. The piers themselves are a little bit taller than that, on the Minnesota approach, about 100 feet to the bridge deck, plus 67 up to the top of the towers. On the Wisconsin side, it's a little bit higher than that, where it's about 140 to 60 feet to the deck level, with 67 feet of towers above that.
Once these large pier casings were clear of all materials, crews installed reinforcement bar cages and pumped concrete to create solid foundations for the new bridge. The next step was to build a footing above the caissons. The footing is the transition component from the caissons to the pier column. In order to safely move forward, crews needed to dry out the work area and remove all the water. To do this, they installed a box-like structure around the prefabricated deck. They then lowered this structure until it reached the river bottom. Once in place, the structure is considered a cofferdam. What's really interesting about this step is that the prefabricated deck that crews used as a work surface up to this point became the base to build the footing at the river bottom. Next, a 3.5 to 4 foot thick layer of concrete is poured underwater. This is called a seal. Once the concrete seal hardened, crews pumped out the water from inside the cofferdam to have a dry working area. The removed water was filtered and returned back to the St. Croix. The dried work area allows crews to construct a reinforced concrete footing on top of the concrete seal. There are 10 footings in total, or 2 at each of the 5 river piers. Crews then constructed a column above each footing in the river. Together, the 10 columns will support 400,000 tons of weight. With the pier columns now above the river surface, crews removed the cofferdam walls, allowing the water to surround each column.
Those underwater foundations will certainly last the expected 100-year duration of the bridge, and quite possibly well beyond that.
Each of the 10 columns stood about 16 feet above the water's surface at the end of 2013.
A lot of the work done in December of 2013 was in extremely cold temperatures. Many days were below zero. The river froze up, A river is not a very fast flowing river, it's more like a lake. And so the ice was forming quite rapidly.
That marked the completion of the work below the water. Next, crews will work to extend the pier columns up to their full height, which will mark the first time the public can see the bridge take shape.